Hello friends and my dear students, once again with another topic of real-time operating system, and in today's lecture we will discuss the medium access control protocol for broadcast network. These are my contents for today's lecture: medium access protocol in CAN, medium access protocol in IEEE 802.5 token ring, prioritized access in IEEE 802.5 token ring pooling, and at last we will discuss timed token medium access control protocol. Now, first of all, what is the medium access control protocol for broadcast network? So the transmission medium of a broadcast network is a processor, and a MAC protocol is a discipline which schedule, we can say, this type of processor. So we have a communication medium. Now, who is going to access that particular communication medium? That is a matter of concern over here, and with the help of the medium access control we are going to resolve this particular matter. And now we are discussing this MAC protocol for the real-time communication system. Earlier might be you have already discussed the MAC protocol in computer networks with the simple data. So the scheduling the transmission medium is done in a distributed manner by network interface of the host in the network. First of all, we will discuss the medium access protocol in CAN, that is a controlled area network. So you might have heard the LAN, WAN, MAN, but over here the another type of the network is the controlled area network, which is a CAN. So it is a very small network, and CAN are used to connect the components of the embedded controllers. An example is an automotive control system like a car, which has the various components like the engine, brake, accelerator. And now how these components are controlled, so that the network by which we are connecting these components will make a CAN, the controlled area network. That's why we are saying the end-to-end length of a CAN must not exceed 100 meters. This means that within the fraction of a bit time, after a station transmits some signal, then all the station should hear the transmission on that particular network. And this transmission of a signal and hearing of that particular, means the transmission and the receiving of that signal, it should be done within a fraction of bit. The output of all stations are wire ended together by the bus. So in a way we are saying all the components are connected together with the end like a bus. On the network, the bit is a logical zero for a particular station. If the output of any station is zero, it means that station is not transmitting anything. And logical one, when the output of all the station is one during that bit time. This CAN MAC protocol is more or less similar to your CSMACD, that is a carrier sense multiple access with collision detection. So when we are saying carrier sense multiple access, so the multiple stations are connected together, they are sharing a carrier, and whenever a station wants to send a packet, first of all it sends the carrier, it sends the medium access, whether that carrier is free or not. If it is free, then and only it sends the packet. And not only it sends the packet during the transmission, it also sends the packet after the packet transmission also, which is required or which is used to identify the collision if there is any between the two packets. So a station with a packet to send wait until it hears that the network is ideal, and then it commences to transmit the ID number of the packet. At the same time, the station also listens. Whenever it hears a zero on the network while it is transmitting one, it interrupts its own transmission, and the network contention is resolved in favor of the packet with the smallest ID among all the contending packets. What does it mean? It means if somebody else is also transmitting, then there is a contention between those stations that can be resolved by the ID number of those particular packets or the ID number of those particular stations. So that is the case for the CAN, the controlled area network. Now, further move on to the next, another standard, which is a IEEE 802.5 token ring, which is a LAN standard. So how the MAC protocol will be taken place in IEEE 802.5 token ring? So in a token ring network, as you know, packets are transmitted only in one direction and in a circular transmission medium. A station transmits a packet by placing its packet on the output link to the network. As the packet circulates around the network, the station identified by the destination address in the header of that particular packet copies the packet. And when the packet returns to the source station, the station removes that particular packet. So that is the case for the token ring. Because as you know, in case of the token ring, a ring has been formed among the various stations. And there is a token circulating among those stations. If any stations wants to communicate or wants to send some data, then it grabs the token, and after grasping that token, it can transmit the packets. So in the similar manner, we are saying, although a little bit difference in the protocol, is that a simple station which wants to transmit a packet, it plays its packet to the output link, and the destination copies that packet if it identifies that, okay, the destination address is mine, then it simply copies the packet. And when this packet reaches to the source station removes that particular packet from the network. Now, how you are going to prioritize, that is the another extension of the previous particular protocol. In the previous protocol, we are saying the MAC for the token ring. Now we are saying the prioritized access in IEEE 802.5 token ring. So we can prioritize. How? That is made possible by using the two groups of three bits each in AC field. That is the header format of that particular packet which is being circulated in the ring. Their value represents the token priority and the reservation priority. And the third token priority bits gives the priority of that particular token. The station can seize the free token only when its outgoing packet priority is equal or higher than the token priority. When a station sees the token, it leaves the token priority unchanged, but set the reservation priority to the lowest priority of the network, so that the other station cannot transmit its packet. Because by lowering the priority, now what we are doing, we are using the reservation priority. In the first case, when it is seizing the free token, so that is for the token priority. And when it is lowering down the priority, it means we are using the reservation priority. So that's why we set the reservation priority to the lowest priority of the network. It then marks the token busy and put the token in the header of the packet and transmit the packet simple. Now, what is the pooling in case of prioritize, or how you are going to do a pooling? So network contention is resolved by pooling mechanism called token passing. So as I've told you, like in case of token ring, there is a token which is being circulated among the various station. A station wants to transmit a packet, first it has to grasp that token. So that is the method of pooling between the various station or for network contention. So for the purpose of the pooling, each bit or each packet has an 8-bit access control field in its header. One of the bit in an AC field is called the token bit. By examining this bit, the current packet on the network, a station can determine whether the network is busy or not. If the network is free, the packet is a pooling packet. As the pooling packet is circulated around the network, the stations are pooled in a round robin manner in order of the physical location of the ring. And this particular pooling packet is called as the free token or simply token, which we have already discussed. When a free token reaches a station that has some outgoing packets waiting in its queue, then it simply sees that free token, and only when it has the highest priority at that particular time, and then it transmit those outgoing packets onto the channel. Now the next is the timed taken medium access control protocol. So earlier one, we have discussed the MAC protocol for the CAN, that is the controlled area network. Then we discuss for the token ring, and now we will discuss for the bus. So if the transmission medium is a bus, then station can pool each other by circulating a, say for example, again the pooling packet or token according to a token circulating list. So there is a circulating list available in the network, according to which a packet is being circulated among the various stations. And according to that particular list, or that list decide the pooling order. So on which order the station will pool the medium. Each station pools the next station downstream according to the circulating list by the broadcasting a token that has the address of the next station in the header. So a station may transmit its data packets only when it is pooled. When it completes its transmission, it transmits the token to the next station downstream, which address is available in the circulating list and in the token address. The prioritized MAC protocol in IEEE 802.4, which is a token bus, and FDDI standard is called a timed token MAC method. So earlier we have used the MAC methods. If we prioritized the IEEE 802.4, that is a token bus, and FDDI standard, now it is called timed token MAC method. And how it prioritized? It prioritized by dividing all the messages into two classes. The one is the synchronous class and the another one is the asynchronous class. The messages which are of periodic nature and have deadlines are called synchronous class. So we can say straightforward, the periodic message is of synchronous class, and for asynchronous class it is aperiodic messages. So based on the periodic and the aperiodic, now it decide first of all the prioritized list. The list which is available, the list over here which we have discussed over here, that is the circulating list. So we prioritize this circulating list, we prioritize this circulating list with the synchronous class, whether the messages belong to the synchronous class or it belongs to the asynchronous class. we will give the priority, but obvious, we will give the priority to the synchronous class, because this type of message are periodic and have deadlines, and that is the case for the real-time system or the real-time data. And with the, we give the least priority to the asynchronous class, where the messages are of aperiodic messages or aperiodic nature, where the messages can miss their deadlines. So each station sets aside some network bandwidth for the transmission of synchronous message and transmit asynchronous message on a time available basis. So each station, we will decide this particular circulating list. Based on this particular circulating list, we will decide that the each station, how or in what time that station will transmit the synchronous message, or in what time it will transmit the asynchronous message. So this is the way by which we can prioritize the MAC method for IEEE 802.4 bus and the FDDI. Thank you, friends. So in the next lecture, we will further discuss some protocol related to the medium access control. Thank you.